This is Metropolis, Fritz Lang's 1927 vision of the city of the future. This is what the 1988 anime classic Akira envisioned Tokyo would look like in 2019. It's always fun to see how close or how wildly far off these predictions are. One of the big misses? The building materials. It turns out that cities of the future might be built out of wood. A wave of architects are embracing wood as the building material of the moment. It arguably started in 2008 in London with the Stadthaus, the first high-density residential timber building above 8 stories tall. By 2014, there were at least 30 taller timber buildings in the works or already completed, and now it's a worldwide wave. In 2018, Japanese developers unveiled plans for the W350 project, a 350-meter tall tower. When it's completed in 2041, it'll be the tallest building in Japan, and it'll be 90% timber, with some steel braces. If 2041 seems way in the future, there are some timber towers that have already been completed. There's the Hoho Tower, set to be complete in 2019 in Vienna, 24 floors high, and the Treat, a 14-story all-timber building completed in Norway in 2015. The reason for this tall timber mania? A convergence of environmental and demographic factors. First, there's the biggie, a growing sense of urgency about climate change. The latest report from the United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change says that to head off total climate disaster, we should limit the rise of global temperature to 1.5 degrees Celsius. To do that, we need to cut our carbon emissions by about half by 2030. Over the past decade, some architects have started promoting timber construction as a carbon-cutting solution.
That challenge means that we have to start thinking in new ways, and I think wood is going to be part of that solution.
According to calculations by one prominent U.S. firm, your typical mid-rise building, made of concrete and steel, will generate over 3,000 tons of carbon dioxide over its construction and lifetime. Build that same mid-rise out of timber, and you avoid the release of over 4,000 tons of carbon dioxide. Trees soak up and store away carbon dioxide as they grow. Every cubic meter of wood stores about a ton of carbon dioxide. A Yale study found that switching from concrete and steel to sustainably managed timber as our building material could reduce global carbon emissions up to 31%. That's what's driving a lot of this push. The other part is a boom in demand for urban housing. By 2050, another 2.5 billion people will live in urban areas. Building with wood is faster and more efficient than building with concrete, and cost competitive too. So that's the big appeal in a nutshell. But let's address the elephant in the room, fire. Building tall with wood isn't actually a new idea. This is the Temple of the Flourishing Law, built in Japan in 607 AD and 32 meters tall. And it's in a rainy, seismically active climate. Not bad. The reason we don't have more old wooden buildings is, of course, fire. London was decimated by the Great Fire of 1666, and that gave birth to the building codes that required the city be rebuilt in stone and brick. New York, San Francisco, Chicago, and Washington, D.C. all had great fires of their own, and those events stuck in the collective memory. So, what's changed? Modern fire suppression techniques, for one, but the crucial change is the material. These new wooden towers aren't being built with light wood frames like this. They're made with timber on steroids, timber that's been engineered to be strong. 20 years ago, researchers discovered that gluing wood in a crisscross pattern, alternating the direction of the grain, negates the weakness of any one piece. That experiment gave birth to this star new building material, cross-laminated timber. Cross-laminated timber, along with a few other types of engineered wood, can also be referred to as mass timber. Mass timber has been subjected to fire safety tests, seismic tests, and blast tests, and has performed as well as or better than steel and concrete. Big slabs of wood, even giant trees, actually perform well in fires. They char on the outside while remaining structurally intact. And when they do catch fire, they burn at a predictable rate. Wood performs well in earthquakes too. Pound for pound, it's just as strong as steel. But because it weighs less, the whole structure has less mass, so when the earth starts rocking, there's less of a load on the foundation. Lightweight is great for seismic safety, but if you want to build really tall, that's a challenge. Stabilizing a very tall but very lightweight structure against lateral forces requires some creative engineering. This is the River Beach Tower, an 80-story, 228-meter tower proposed for Chicago. To stabilize a wooden tower this tall, its entire bottom third would need to be solid wood. So, the designers spread the load between two foundations connected via an atrium and added a honeycomb frame. While we're here, check out the exposed wood inside. That's another reason architects are turning to timber. Research shows that a connection to natural materials in our environment helps increase our sense of well-being. This is just a concept, though. As cool as it would be to see something like this in real life, super tall timber is not quite ready for prime time. These designs are still conceptual, meant to expand ideas about what's possible. There are still debates and engineering puzzles, technical details to figure out through more research and peer review. Plus, current technology and industry knowledge make super tall timber super expensive. That super tall tower in Japan, the developers acknowledge that if they were to build it today, it would cost double the price of a conventional super tall tower. Super tall timber might be a ways away, but the mid-rise mass timber boom is definitely on, with Europe and Canada leading the way. But there's one more thing. The whole idea of mass timber as a sustainable material hinges on that wood coming from forests that are sustainably managed. And that's a pretty big if. We've seen in the past that governments have lacked the will or the capacity to practice sustainable forest management, but that's like a whole other video. Would you live in a tall timber building? Hit the comments to tell us why or why not. And hit the bell icon to get notified when Cheddar posts a new video. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.